Welcome back to Let's Play Lies 3. In the last part, yeah, a lie spread it. The thief stole the Auric Antique. And yeah, it's a total mess this time. Lies are forming, but not really. They're all like muddy, like this here. And even if we beat them, Effie can't really eat them at the moment. And yeah. We know one of the mates is lying, at least. So we are going to search for some evidence. And I guess this memo pad could be... Oh? Crumbled paper? Not really. What's this? It smells weird, and it's powdery. Medicine bag? Empty. Guess it was already used. It's gray and white. One of the mates said that. Let's show her this. Got medicine bag. Okay. Let's talk to her then. She handed something to him. I think that's what she was doing. Yeah. Show an item. Medicine bag. Ah, that must be it. I see, it was a medicine bag. The master hasn't been feeling particularly well lately. So he's, been having medicine. And, he has it before bed. Almost every day, I think. Who gives him the medicine? The master specified he didn't want us to know who. Specified the mates can't know? Why? I keep looking for things to show the mates. Okay. Still gotta search for stuff, I guess. Nothing here, nothing here. I guess it's in the other rooms, but I still... Something's written... Thank you again, I put it here as usual. This is some messy writing. Maybe that's why it was crumpled and tossed. Seems like the master was communicating with someone. Now if we had the other person's message, that would be nice. Memo pad? Not there, I guess. Trash can, nothing in. Okay, let's look for more stuff. Oh, this is really, really creepy. Okay, let's see. Maybe in this trash can? Nope. Oh, we can rest here. Okay. Even though I wouldn't really want to rest here. I wonder if the key got dropped somewhere. Or hidden? Yeah, it might not be far from here. Okay. Okay, go get it. Oh, it's under the table. Woo! Here! It's a key. Got a key. Whoa, lots of made of outfits. Hey, check the pockets. You start from the right. Okay. Found something. Well, look at it. Sparkly and big. This seems to be the only one. Well, let's take this uniform. Can I wear it? No. Oh. You can take a different one. Okay. Let's show it to that maid. Got maid uniforms. Can I actually equip it to her? I can. Cool. It's the first time we can actually... change the equipment on this. That's really cool. So let's rest up again. And search for some other stuff first. Here's nothing. Okay. And I can't go in there. Alright. Guess that's all we can have for now. It's undeniable that it's one of these girls. Because we are the only ones who wear this kind of maid uniform. Yeah, show an item. We have the maid uniform, I guess. What about it, uniform? What? What's this huge gem? Do you know who would have worn this uniform? Only two of us wear this size. A maid with the bob cut and a maid with the ponytail. The goody two-shoes and I are one size smaller than that. Anything else you know? One of the servants said they took some photos, but the very next day they suddenly stopped coming to work. And no one's found the photos. Thank you very much. Narrows things down. If only we had the notes that we are communicating with. I don't feel like this is going to end well. Okay, so it's not those two. You or you? really not sure. Maybe I do need another note. No. That's what we already had. Okay. This was new. Trash can? Should we check all the trash cans? Behind the trash can. Okay, we got a tip there. Glop. We're leaving you alone because I can destroy you anyway. Behind the trash can, maybe this one? Nope. There are only a few trash cans left. Some waiter. Photos? Lots of them! Some kind of delivery going on in this. That medicine? Can see the face though. There's a mark on the back of the maid's hand. The sleeve covers it a little, but it means you're in a gang.
Gang?
A group of bad guys. Gangs tend to put some mark on their members' bodies. Yeah, back on the left hand is the most common one.
This mark?
There's even a photo of handing over a note. Kinda small, but I got the antique, the leader says pay soon. Doing business with a gang. Was that how he got that? Auric antique thing, too? I see. This place is that close by, is it? Have you been here before? This may be a rich town, but right beside it are the poor slums.
Sit?
No, forget it. Let's just show these pictures to that maid. Some photos, okay. Let's see then. One of you said... Not sure I can show it to you. Not to you. I have to show it to one of you, I guess. But I can't really remember. Wait a second. Mess is sickly as of late. I'm just trying to show it to her. What about it? Must be not the right item. Okay. So it's you.
Photos?
Do you see anything familiar in these photos? No, I don't. Wouldn't that make me the culprit if I did? So then, would you show me the back of your left hand? Sure, I don't mind. Here you go.
No mark. So that maid was lying?
And the note seen in this photo here. Could you possibly tell from the handwriting who wrote it?
It's too small to tell.
Maybe if you showed me the actual note, I could...
I see.
Do you know anything about your master's sickness?
I don't know the name or anything, but apparently it's difficult to cure.
I feel like he's not getting better at all. Rather, he's just getting worse.
Worse, you say?
Yes, all the other employees are worried for him.
You know for sure, right?
Yeah, let's show her these photos too. Okay, we shall show her the photos as well. Have you ever seen anything from these photos?
No, I haven't.
Then would you show me the back of your left hand?
Alright.
Huh? There's nothing? Oh, what is it? Could you please try to find the culprit instead of wasting time?
Yes, I'm sorry to bother you.
Any change in the lie?
No, if the liar won't admit it, it's not going to take form.
Then we need proper proof, like a bag with medicine still in it, or the note in that photo.
If we show her those, she's got to own up.
I'll take another look at that room with the maid uniforms. Okay, then let's go there. Ah, look who's there.
Miss Iris!
You two, so you were on this floor? Captains Niels and Bright arrived, and they're keeping the civilians under the control downstairs.
They got in?
Yes, barely. Vice Captain Bright's ability found a gap to get in through. But shortly afterward, the goop spread further. It now seems impossible for anyone else to enter or exit. That's why I'm headed for the rooftop as well.
Well, we're a bit stuck.
Yes, that's worrying.
Can you wait here a sec? We'd like your help.
Yes, certainly. If we find the medicine, we'll get Iris to identify it.
Okay. So in this room. Trash can?
Nope.
Here somewhere?
Nope.
Somewhere around here? Nope. Any suspicious crannies?
Hmm? Oh look, it's hard to tell, but I think this comes off.
It's the same medicine bag we found in the trash.
Bingo. Let's see what that investigator thinks of this.
Okay.
Is this the medicine?
Yes, we'd like you to tell us what kind.
Piece of cake, I'll be done in a flash.
Wow, that face.
Like a cat scaring. Didn't you say exactly the same thing before? Never say it again.
Ah, this is poison.
Poison?
Yes, but not a fast-acting one. It's a kind of kind that slowly eats away at the body.
And what would happen if you took this every day?
This much once a day. I suppose you'd be quite weak after a month or so.
After that, death would be highly probable within a week or less.
Thanks. That's a big help.
Can we proceed upward now?
Well, probably. Just give us a little time.
Now for that note.
Question is, do I find something more for the note or not?
Is it in that stack of notes? Not expecting much, but let's check. Okay.
These are all new sheets. That's not that note's not in here.
Well, if you can't find it anywhere, then let's make it.
Hmm?
With a pencil. Listen, don't bother me. I'm concentrating.
Phew. Wow, I've never seen that the action note, but it looks just like the photo one.
It's so small in the photo that it took a while to copy. But this should do.
Whether works, works. Let's go.
Oh no, he just copied it. Got exchanged notes.
Okay, I guess that's a way to do it.
I thought he was like trying to see if the one writing on the note block, if the written stuff was pushed on the lower one, so you can use a pencil to see what was written on the upper one. But okay, let's see.
Hey, do you know the culprit yet? You've been asking us question after question.
Yes, I do. Let me explain in order.
There is indeed a maid who is overly close with her master, frequently communicating with him.
And that maid is?
Some of the mark of a red spider tattooed on the back of her left hand. That tattoo being a symbol of a gang that bases itself on the slums near this town.
Gang?
Your master had connections with the gang. He did business with them.
The leader of that gang will do anything for you if you can pay the money.
Even the focus on of this very party. I believe even the auric antique was obtained via the gang's help. The maid in question wears the same uniform as you four. And you stated that only you four wear this design, correct?
Yes, that's right.
The master has varied tastes, so he has many different kinds of maid uniform.
Tastes in maids? Like cat ears?
Weirdo.
I see. Thank you for that info. Now about these uniforms.
A gem was found in the pocket of this uniform here. Coming from its size, clearly it would be quite valuable.
And in this note, which I believe the master wrote,
thank you again, I put it here, put it there as usual.
Can you confirm this is without a doubt your master's writing?
Yes, I believe. This curly elegant writing is indeed our master's.
Eh?
We can clearly surmise it refers to a payment. He communicated with this maid and sent her payment. The payment is the gem found inside the uniform. Perhaps you can connect the dots.
Well then, who is this maid?
Indeed, just tell us your conclusion.
Well, only you four wear these uniforms.
And only the ponytail and bob cut maids wear this size of it.
Huh? It's not me though.
I'm not a culprit either.
I mean, you didn't even find a tattoo on me, did you?
Yes, but I did find this.
Oh, is that the response to that note?
That's right. The prior one was written by your master. But this one reads, I got the antique leader says, pay soon.
This is the reply of the maid he was talking to.
We're down to two culprits. It should be easy to tell which one wrote this, yes?
Isn't this real writing?
It most certainly is. This is yours, isn't it? Then is there any doubt that you are the culprit? But the tattoo? Maybe I didn't mention you could always be hiding it, with foundation or the like. I have some cleansing cream in my pocket if you need it. Well, want us to try it? Ah, fine, it's me. So what? Stop howling like damn monkeys about this. He told me he disposed of everything, but he clearly didn't. He's just taking, just a monkey too, isn't he? Me? Wow, she looks scary. I don't give a crap about that soft-headed mohawk guy. Our lead is a million times more handsome. You guys have no taste. What did you say? With the culprit exposed, there's one more thing. This is the medicine you were giving to your master. We found it to be poison. What's the meaning of this? Oh, that. The leader told me to, so I just gave it to Mohawk every day. Guess it's been late with payments lately. Can't complain about getting poisoned then, can you? You really are the gang sort, aren't you? I knew you were suspicious. You barely did cleaning or laundry, and even walked funny. Huh? Aren't you to blame for those stinky toilets? And always wearing the same clothes? They are really arguing. Well, getting what with these gangs never turns out well. But now that she'd admitted her lie, I can eat that monster. The, I won. Good luck with that. Okay. Let's go and eat the eye. The really disgusting eye. Gross lie. Oh god. Okay. Let's kill it. Fast. With fire. Ah, that didn't even do much damage. Let's see what the normal damage does. Pretty much the same. But at least it does a lot of damage. And Dragonhide learned. No, I never wanna eat a lie like that again. Didn't eat it at all. Is that gonna be okay? Yeah, I just ate until I couldn't make any more goopy lies. And I don't wanna eat anymore. Ah, please. Yeah, I give you some sweets to clear the taste. Oh, cream puffs. Okay. Quite easily entertained, I guess. This is still mudded up. This was this room. Just going to take a little break here. And I guess we can go to the rooftop now. Yeah, we can. Huh? What? Got all mudded up again. And no way back again. Just have to keep moving. Aha. Hello there. Ah, we meet again. How are you faring, brother? You said it before. Why the hell? I don't have any siblings. I can't be your brother. Hmm. Have you really forgotten? Perhaps because I'm much more talkative than I once was. It certainly has been a long, long time. Perhaps this will jog your memory? One of the kids. Well, Theo? You're Cyril. So you do remember after all. Ah, that's right. You seem to remember your brother Enos as well. Were you accomplices from the beginning? Well, well, who can say? There's nothing to do with you either way, brother. Traitor. You don't want to talk, do you? Fine by me. You there, Dragon Girl. Are you alright? It seems to be proving quite effective. Almost scary how well it works, I'd say. You mean how I can't control my power? Yes, when we first met, do you recall that ringing? It was an ultrasonic wave which destabilized your power. Though it's a human at fault for the lie spreading so much. Were you not after the Auric Antique then? What benefit is it to you making her power unstable? It's true, I'm a phantom thief. I do need to steal the treasure. Yet, this seems to be a fake, couldn't you tell? Wealthy folks are so clueless in that regard. At any rate, the treasure was not the focus here. You asked me if I had a grudge against you. I know you, so I suppose you must already realize, Theo. Lying makes one succumb to the lies, was it? Then, why not you, brother Theo? Is simply lying more to make the lies unclear?
Lying on top of lies?
You're just desperately hiding. I wouldn't be surprised to see it crumble soon enough. Don't worry, I'll help you with that.
Ooh. Okay, we are fighting him.
That's a bit unexpected, but okay. He's storing power. Which means we will defend a bit. And then I guess attack him. With up defense, I guess this was good damage. Okay, we're still really fine against him. He has no chance at all. Bam, bam. And now go away. Thank you. Big lie learned, how learned. Ah. That sound again. What's the gang need from the stomping grounds of kids? Ah, it's a flashback. Did you steal a gun? Speak up. I don't know. Didn't get the wrong people, did they? Crap, they found out about the things we stole before too? What can we do? What if they'll kill us? Stop it. Don't say that stuff, okay? But they're really mad. We're talking about going against the gang here. Then I'll talk with their leader. So you stay here for now. We're not gonna run. This is our turf, ain't it? There's nowhere to run. It was our mistake. We should. You don't need to come. Just wait here. Sid, are you being taken by the lies? Sid!
Don't touch me. Listen. Don't come any closer.
How fragile. Well, it shouldn't be long now. Let's move this along, shall we?
Where's Sid? I'm alone. Was he trying to keep from being possessed all along? I protect him. I promise him that. I have to go save him. I'm scared. Sid.
Wow, this story is really way darker than before.
But we'll go after Sid in the next part. Till then, see ya.